everybody. Hope we're all fit and well. No illness, no injuries, nothing we need to worry about. So we're going to start off as normal, setting ourselves up, standing nice and tall, drawing that tummy in, arms at our side, shoulders back, and take a little lean forwards to just before you think you're going to fall, and then back. That's it. So catching our weight on our toes, back to just before you think you're going to go. If you are, take that step, catch yourself. And when you're falling over, that's it. So just a few times, it wakes those senses up, it finds our balance point, just gets us set ready to move. So we've got a couple more. That's good. Then find that spot where you feel nicely balanced. You don't feel you're falling forwards or back. Hands onto hips or one hand in front behind. Tilt our pelvis under, then put the arch in the bottom of the spine. So just tilting under and back. You can soften those knees a little. Just put you in the right posture. That's good. Just a few times, loosens off that lower back. If we've been lying down in bed all night, just gets us moving again. Couple more. Find that spot now, we should be nicely balanced, we have a neutral spine, feet under our hips, we're just going to raise those hands, open out wide, and down, so up, open, in, and down, so take a nice deep breath as we stretch out, blow it out as you come down, that's it. Going. Excellent. A few more. One more time. Then this time we're going to take those hands high and wide. We're going to sweep that in front and then open out wide. So to start with, we're just sweeping those arms, open out and sweep. And we're just going to gradually increase this range of movement. So just start to take a little bit of a dip down. Increasing that movement, adding in a little bend of the knees, a little bit more, that's good, so open up wide, so you get that little lean back as we open out, cross it over in front, so taking that bigger if you can. Times. So a couple more. Last one. And bringing that back up. Okay, so standing high, I'm just going to take a little reach. Out to the side now. Looking towards your hand. So they go wider and wider. I'm going to start adding a little bit of rotation in soon. So if you are struggling with that, just do what you can. Work to your level. And start looking round, reaching over that shoulder. That's good. If you find you're a little bit dizzy, slow it down, take a little break, whatever you need. So looking round over that shoulder now. That's it. And taking it into our rotations. So sweeping around, nice and steady. And release your outer heel so that when you look, you can turn all the way, looking right round behind. Center, just give yourself a few seconds, let your balance come back, get yourself centered again. And we're going to raise that knee, so standing tall, bringing that knee up to about hip height if we can, if not, just wherever you're able. That's it. Aiming to keep standing as tall and still as we can. So getting ourselves set. So a few more, we're just going to add to it. So we're going to add in a little bit of a lean. So we're going to bring that knee up. We're going to take it back. Up and back. So you keep your hands down, but if you want to bring your arms forwards as you lean, that's totally up to you. So you can add that movement in, or keep hands to hips. Difficult, stick with the basic exercise. That's it. This is the point where I should put my mat further forwards. I'm kicking the wall behind me every time I move. That's it. Good, a couple more. Okay, so we're standing nice and tall again. We're just going to sweep that leg forwards and back. It doesn't have to be a huge movement. Just sweeping that through. Then aim to stand as tall and still as we can. So arms either down your side, on your hips, or if you need support with your balance, then take them out. If you really struggle, like touching a piece of furniture or the wall, try not to lean too much to the side, just enough to allow your foot to clear the floor. Good. One more. Bringing that down, reset onto the other leg. So you're standing tall. We're sweeping through. Tall back, not leaning in, not leaning to the side too much. Do a couple more. Bring that back down. Switching back over onto the other leg. You're going to draw that circle around your standing leg. Again, just wherever your arms naturally go, whether that's onto your hips, whether that's hanging down, holding onto the wall to stop you falling over. That's good. A couple more. into that other leg, sweeping around. Chest up. That's it. Very good. Squeeze the bum, push up the thighs. Standing tall. Keeping those muscles strong. Help us get in and out of our chairs. Walk up and down stairs. It's really important. Natural movements that we need to do. Shoulder width, toes pointing outwards, keeping our head and chest up. Let's squat down again. Get aiming for about that 90 degree bend in your knee if you can. If not, just wherever you're able. That's it, keeping that head up, looking forwards. Bum and the inner thighs as we're coming back up. So just feel it hitting those muscles in a different direction. Slightly different exercise. That's good. So a little tweak now as we go down, we're going to pause, go to our toes and up. Excellent, keeping that going, well done. Few more. We'll do two more. Onto toes, up. Last one, and bringing that back up, well done. Okay, taking it to the end of your mat if you're not already. Looking lengthways down that, hands high. Rolling it down to the ground. Slowly unroll, bringing that up. Reach to the sky, and down. Soften those knees as you go down. And hopefully finding each time you're going a fraction lower as that postural train stretches and warms up and loosens off. Oh. down one more time, down towards those feet, let it hang. So just let it hang there for a few seconds. And then hands on that, walk it forward. Now into that straight arm plank position. We're holding. To our knees, sitting back on those heels, stretch through that upper body. And relax it there. Okay, so we're starting off in a sitting position. I want you to sit down on your mat with your legs extended. So legs straight out in front of you. Sitting up nice and tall. To begin with, we're just going to reach up above our head and then bend forwards, reaching for those toes and slide it back until you're sitting vertical again. Reach up, forwards, slide it back. That's it. It's a really nice stretch out to begin with, and then we'll add to this exercise. But to begin with, a really nice loosener and stretch. That's it, a couple more. So this time we're going to extend it into our reverse plank. So we're going to reach towards those feet, hands on the mat, slide those hands back to just behind the bum, lift it up, look to the ceiling. Back down and reach. Slide back. Good, keep that movement going. That's it, a few more times. Good, we'll do two more. Last one. And rest that in. Okay, so this time, slightly different. So I'll just turn around so you can see. So I want you to sit with your legs out straight again. We're going to lift one leg out. So a semicircle sort of pattern as you lift out to the side, back in. So picture a water bottle or something that you've got to lift that leg up and over. So we're coming up and over. Bring it in. Aim to keep yourself sitting up nice and tall. So if you need to put your hands back to support, that's fine. Or you can keep them just to your sides. So just one leg at a time. It's one of those things that looks and sounds a dead easy exercise until you've done a few. Thank you. Say a couple more each side. One more. That's it. If you need to bring those legs in, have a little stretch or stretch out. Whatever you need, squeeze those out. Okay, we're gonna keep going, similar position. You probably will want to put your hands back for this one. So we're gonna try and do it with both legs together. It won't be as big a movement. So we're just gonna try and lift and down, back to center. So hands wherever you need, whether that's forwards or back, however you feel you need to put them. Experiment, see what works best for you with a hand position. And to counterbalance the weight of your legs, you probably will need to lean back more. If you do find that too difficult, go back to your single leg. We'll do one more each way. Last one. And bringing that in. Excellent. Well done. Okay, so we're laying back onto your mat now. So extend your legs straight. Lay yourself back. Hands behind your head. We can do our leg slide, but with that reverse action. So we're bringing the leg in. I want you to bring both arms up and down, opposite leg. So it's one leg, two arms. Keeping that foot just skimming the ground. So breathe in as you go back, breathe out on the effort of raising the arms. Breathe in, breathe out. Good. Making sure that heel's just skimming over the ground. It's not lifting high. Excellent. A few more. One more each leg. And resting that down. This time we're going to bring those feet up into your tabletop. Hands pointing to the ceiling, so we're in that dead bug position. I'm going to tap one toe down. Focus on that lower back. Do you feel that arching up? Starts to arch more than this normal natural position. Engage that core, pull the pelvis back. So we take that arch back to where it should be. Really good, keeping that going. Say one more each leg and bring those knees in, give those a nice hug, have a good stretch out in the lower back. Okay, so we're laying back into that same position again, but this time with our arms on the floor. We're going to go for our knee drop side to side. It's the double knee drop. Dropping down, hands in that slight V position on the mat, and let let those knees drop. When your shoulder lifts, that's when we bring it back up and over. So arms are just there for balance and support. The effort of moving those knees is done through the core. So we breathe in as the knees drop, breathe out on the effort of lifting. And breathe in, breathe out with that effort. Taking it in and out. Good. Keeping that going. Sit nice and steady. A few more times. Good. Once more each way. Last one. And bringing that back in. Okay, sitting yourself back up. So sitting nice and tall with that straight back, knees bent. We're taking those arms forwards. We're just going to gently roll that back. Bring it back up to sitting tall. So we don't need to lean any further forwards from that vertical position. Just slowly back. Bring it up. Really focus on curving that spine, that rolling movement, just as far back as you feel you can, if that's just there, and back up straight, absolutely fine. If you're feeling stronger and you want to take that further back, great. If you want to go nearly all the way down, fantastic. Just try and stay a fraction off that mat. That way we keep the tension in those abdominals all the time. That's good. Keep it going, a few more. Two more. One more time. Bring that back. Let's take it up. This time going all the way to the mat. Take it back. Hands around, legs straight. We're going to roll up. So bring those hands over. When you see them, lift the head, tuck the chin, roll the shoulders, curl towards the feet. Slowly back. Unroll that spine, one vertebra at a time onto the mat, hands over. Eyes follow your hands. That's good. So if you do struggle with this one, then you need to just use your hands to give that little lift over that sort of dead spot, so if you need a little pull or push to get past there, absolutely fine. Keep it that minimum support. Or you can always use that invisible rope that helps you pull up. You can pull yourself forwards, lower yourself back with that invisible rope as you go up and down. That's it. A few more. Good, we'll do two more. Taking that back. One more time. toes, can you hold, have a little stretch, and relax that there. Okay, going over onto our fronts now. So I want you to lay face down onto your mat, elbows at that 90 degree position, legs extended behind. You're going to start with that torso raise, so just lifting head and chest off the mat, back down. We are going to build the exercise a little as we go. So we're starting, just raise that torso, using those muscles in the back, arms just for position and support. We're not lifting with the arms at all yet. Using those muscles in the back, all along the spine. Couple more, we're going to start to extend the movement. So on the next one, we're going to straighten those arms, we're going to lift, shake it up, and back down. That's it. Another progression here. So next time, as we lower down, when we get to the mat, we're going to raise one leg down, torso raise down, lift the other leg back up. So one torso raise, one leg lift. Leg lift initiates in the lower back, through the glute, along the hamstring. That's good. A few more times. So once more each leg. Last one now. One torso raise to end. And back down. Okay, you're gonna stay in that same position. Laid face down on the mat, we're going to bring our arms forwards this time. We're going to do that VW movement, so we're going to raise, squeeze those elbows down and shoulder blades together, extend and lower. So back down onto your mat, we'll start with that, then we'll reel out the leg action, action in. Let's go, squeeze, forwards, down. So really squeeze our shoulder blades together. That's it. So after your next one, we're going to add in those legs.
squeeze together, extend, down, raise the feet, squeeze those heels together, 8 times, that's it, down, back, one arm action, 8 of those heel taps. Good. One more of each. Last arm action. Down onto those legs. 7, 8, and rest it there. Bring yourself up now. Coming into a kneeling box position. So we've got our hands on the shoulders. Knees under hips. I'm just going to extend into that Superman. Bring it back. Nice and long and straight. Try not to lift that leg too high. A few more. And we'll just change it up a little bit. So what we're going to do when we change it up, we're going to extend and then we're going to move our leg, tapping from one side to the other in a bit of a semicircle. So next time we're going to pause, we're going to extend, we're going to tap over the other side, tap. We're going to tap a few times, holding that position so that toe taps the floor. Goes over the other leg, taps at the other side. That's it. One more each side. And bring that in. Swap to the leg. So we extend, pause, and then tap one side to the other. Side, bring it in, good, back to the other side, so the aim is to keep everything else still other than that leg that's doing the taps side to side. A few more. Good, one more each way. Bring it back in. So from that box position, we're just going to arch that spine up. And let it drop, rotate through the shoulders, head up. And rotate, arch that spine up again, head down, looking up down, letting that hand stretch and looking up. Back to neutral, sit back on those heels, stretch it out through the upper body, sitting back on those heels. Good, and slowly bring that up, back up to our feet. That's it, take your time getting back up and down on the floor quite a while, so don't want to go dizzy. So standing tall, we're going to take one foot back, bend that front knee, stretching that calf. Just make sure that foot's nice and straight, the heel's not turned in or out. Gives that better stretch through the calf. Hands together, reach out, head down. And change, swap the feet, other foot goes back. This time, hands in the small of the back or reaching behind you. Chest forward, shoulder blades together. Look to the side. And then the other side. And bring that back round. Let's stand tall, picking one foot up. Switch over, pick the other foot up. That's good. Feet back down, feet under those hips, hands above the head. Let's just reach down for those toes. And bring that back up. Feet out wide just one time today. So we're going to sweep through, reach for the sky, up on those toes, reaching high for 3, 2, 1, and relax it there. Well done, everybody.